Hey, Mad Dog Nation, Dr. Tom Hansen here with another Mental Game Monday. Today, I'm going to talk about one of the biggest topics I think there is out there, and especially big because no one talks about it, and that is how important it is for a coach to keep in mind the design of a human when considering coaching. I mean, if I said, oh man, I have a problem with my computer, I call up a guy who knows more about the design of my computer than I do. I'm limited into what I can do. Here's knows more about it. His first question, is it an Apple or a PC? Big question, because they're designed differently. And so he maybe can work on one, but not the other. But what we tend to do as coaches is just look at a player and think that we just know how things are without really leveraging the information that we have about the design of a human being. And today I want to talk about maybe the most important part, which is the brain and how it's actually functioned, how it actually is designed and functioned, and the ramification of that. It's a quickie version. We've got three parts to the brain. The number one thing to know is that the cortex, the big thing that's like a computer that stores information, enables you to think about grade school or what it might be like on your deathbed, boom, boom, time travel, cortex thing, storage cortex. Oh, remember that? Yeah, cortex thing. And that's what I'm talking to you with mostly. And that's what we tend to do as coaches is we think of the person as having a cortex, which they do. But there's a second part of your brain. It's called the mammalian brain. And there's a lot that this thing does too, but the one I want to emphasize is that it wires us for being in groups. Mammals like to be in groups. We're mammals, we like to be in groups, herds, tribes. And we it's wired in that we think being out of that means death. So when we get kicked out of a group, the loneliness we're afraid of, but more important, it's hard to hunt and gather. And we certainly can't reproduce alone. So that's what's going on with the mammalian brain. It's like, oh, I'm going to be in a group. I'm going to be in a group. I'm going to connect, going to connect. And the last part, reptilian brain. That's all about safety. If you've read Play Big, you know what it's about with this inner umpire. So here's the thing, though. The big distinction is that the cortex and the mammalian brain are add-ons to the lizard, to our inner lizard. That's really what we have first, and it's added on. Like if you have a Chevy truck, you can add stuff on, right? But it's always that Chevy truck. It's not, it's not any other kind of truck. And it's not a Lexus. It's a Ford. For better or for worse, that's what it is. And you can add on all you want, but it's still this. And that's with us too. You can add on all we want, but we're still at our heart run by a lizard. And so that lizard, safe, am I safe, am I safe, am I safe, am I safe? And if the mammalian brain is saying like, hey, I might get kicked out. If I choke here and this at bat, if I don't come through, I could get kicked out of the tribe. That's death. Boom, lizard lights up. And what the lizard can do is fight. It can freeze. It can run, flee, or it can just go fail. I'll give up. Can quit. So the biggest cause of problem, baseball is run by safety. It's all about safety. Yes, the safety of a guy, say, getting hit in the head. But in terms of performance, it's all about does a guy feel safe? If he's out there and he chokes, he doesn't feel safe. If he's underperforming significantly, you can just go right to safety. And that's what we don't do a good job of, is looking at players through a lens of safety. And the other thing is, whatever someone does, it makes sense to them. We're going to be coherent. It makes sense that they're that way. It makes sense that they have the problem that they have. It makes sense that they act the same because of how it's all wired back to and relates back to their safety. So you got to keep that in mind. Ramifications, if you're coaching, is create a safe context in which then you can challenge a person. But if they feel unsafe, then they're not going to have full access to their talent because they're going to be fighting or freezing. You know, mostly freezing, froze. So if you freeze, it's, you know, here's a ball coming at me. Oh no, it broke over the plate. I kicked in my safety thing, and that's what's going on there. So that's a very powerful lens as you are looking at going out with your mad dog bat, as you ought to be, and crushing a baseball or helping other people crush the baseball. You want to establish a sense of safety. How can I make this person be safe? Or what as a player can you do that makes you feel safe? That's really what all my stuff, anyway, builds on that one premise. Feel safe and then get free to play great. So, Mad Dog Nation, get out there and feel safe, or get out there and make someone else feel safer today. And that Mad Dog Nation is getting out there and playing big. Thank you.